In this video, we'll talk about the Calvin cycle and carbon fixation. So let's talk about the second step of photosynthesis. The Calvin cycle functions like a sugar-producing factory. Within the chloroplast, it uses carbon dioxide and the chemical energy generated by the light reactions to form glucose. This process is known as carbon fixation. Carbon fixation is specifically taking carbon in an inorganic form, like carbon dioxide, and converting it into an organic molecule, like glucose. Going from inorganic to organic is what makes it carbon fixation. Now, in order to make an organic molecule, one thing that's required is a bunch of high-energy electrons. The NADPH molecules, which were produced during the light reactions, contain these high-energy electrons. You may remember we had described NADPH as a shuttle bus for electrons. Well, these electrons are going to be dropped off. They're going to be added to carbon dioxide along with some hydrogen protons to form sugar. Much of the energy of the sugar molecule will be found in these high-energy electrons. In fact, we'll look at the role these high-energy electrons play when we discuss cellular respiration. So here we have our entire equation for photosynthesis. We have our reactants at the top of this diagram being water and carbon dioxide. And we see the water is going into the light reactions, the CO2 is going into the Calvin cycle. We also have light, which is supplying the energy for this chemical reaction. Well, coming out of the light reactions, we have oxygen gas, which is one of our chemical products, and we also have ATP and NADPH. These are two forms of chemical energy. That chemical energy from the light reactions is going to combine with the carbon dioxide in the Calvin cycle to form glucose. So water and carbon dioxide go into photosynthesis, oxygen gas and sugar come out. Water specifically goes into the light reactions and out comes oxygen gas and the chemical energy. CO2 and the chemical energy go into the Calvin cycle and out comes glucose, an organic molecule that also is very energy rich. This sugar molecule can now be stored and used later by the plant, or also by animals which consume that plant. The last aspect of photosynthesis to discuss is the impact that photosynthesis has on the atmosphere. And the answer is a lot. There's a big impact on the atmosphere because of photosynthesis. It's what adds oxygen gas to the atmosphere while using up carbon dioxide. In fact, oxygen gas is a highly reactive molecule, and so all of the oxygen gas currently in our atmosphere was generated by photosynthesis. In fact, if there were not a constant supply of plants and protists performing photosynthesis, the oxygen gas in our atmosphere would be depleted as it reacts with other molecules on the surface of the Earth. So with that, that finishes our discussion of photosynthesis. In the next video, we are going to talk about cellular respiration, or how it is we go about getting the energy out of the sugar molecules produced by photosynthesis. Thanks for your attention. See you in the next video.